Hey, what's going on, everybody? So it's the holiday season, and a lot of people are concerned about gaining weight over the holidays, right? Eating cookies and desserts and things like that. So I went and bought a cookie just because I want to make this video. And I've been wondering how many people, you know, buy cookies and then put them on a nice plate and then pretend at parties like you made them. But anyhow, so will eating cookies make us gain weight over the holidays? So I looked up, like, what's in a cookie? Now, this is very important because a lot of people don't realize this is so important. All right. So what's in a cookie? Biggest ingredient, flour. Now, I would argue that flour is worse than sugar. It's like, how could you say that? So all flour is sugar bound together, right? So when you digest flour, your digestion means you break the bond, and it's just sugar hits your bloodstream instantly, all right? But on top of the sugar, they add synthetic vitamins. They enrich it. And what enrich means is you add back these synthetic vitamins, vitamins that don't exist in nature, to add some sort of nutritional value to the flour. Otherwise, it's literally just like eating sugar. But on top of that, you have gluten and other things inside of it that is bad for people. It can damage your digestive system, and it causes all kinds of health problems. And it's just crazy, right? So that's the main ingredient. And then, of course, you add more sugar on top of that to call it a sugar cookie. And then you have some butter in there, an egg, which is by far the healthiest part of the cookie, and then a little bit of baking soda or baking powder or a little bit of both. Now, would you agree with me that eating this is not healthy? Like, these ingredients are very, very bad. Would you agree? Yes, you're shaking your head. Yes, you have. I mean, if you don't agree, you're just wrong, okay? So either you agree or choose to be wrong. Those are the only options, okay? So this is, it's bad. Like, no one would ever start off their kid's meal or your own meal with sugar cookies, right? It's like, well, what are we having for breakfast, honey? Ah, we're having sugar cookies. Like, what? It's like, that's awful. We would never have sugar cookies for breakfast because it's so bad. Here's the other thing, too. You have to realize, it's so bad. Not only is it a bunch of, what you're getting is a whole bunch of calories, right? And added, like, excess calories, your body takes all these sugars and stores it as fat, which is bad. But it's like, it's next to zero nutritional value. So you're getting a bunch of useless calories, right? And no nutrition. It's terrible. You just agreed it's terrible, or you didn't and you're foolish, right? So what's a pancake made out of? Looked it up. How do you make homemade pancakes? Flour, sugar, instead of butter, you add a little milk, right? Egg, baking soda, baking powder. All a pancake is a freaking sugar cookie, right? With a little more flour, a little less sugar. Same ingredients, different ratio, right? And instead of frosting on top, you add syrup. So how many days, how many kids start off their day with pancakes? Like, and it's not even like if you give a kid a cookie, you'd be like, oh no, honey, just have one cookie. They're not good for you. But if a kid has, if you're making pancakes, like, oh, you want some more pancakes, honey? I got more pancakes over here. You encourage them to eat more. It's the same thing, right? It's like, well, what about a muffin? What's a muffin made out of? Flour, sugar, and then vegetable oil. And it's like, vegetable oils aren't made from vegetables. It's a processed grain oil. It's just awful for you. Plus maybe some egg, but baking soda, baking powder. So of the three, I would argue a muffin is the worst for you. And how many people, like, start a day with a muffin thinking it's good for them when actually it's probably worse than a sugar cookie, right? And we could keep going. You could add French toast, toast and jelly, cereal, waffles, whatever, it's all this, like, pretty much the typical standard American recommended breakfast is freaking sugar cookies. And then you wonder why kids are sick all the time, right? So a whole bunch of sugar, it's terrible for your immune system, right? So then you go to these schools and those kids are just sick all the freaking time. And then people have the gall to blame their kids for catching something and being sick. It's like, well, when you feed them this kind of garbage all the time and it's just crushing their immune system, how could they not be sick all the time? Whose fault is that, right? It's just, it's insane. And it's part of the problem is we just don't know, right? But now you do. Now you know that pancakes is a sugar cookie, right? A muffin is a sugar cookie, a waffle, toast and jelly. You're giving your kids sugar cookies or worse than sugar cookies on a regular basis. And then you have juice next to it, which is just sugar water, right? And then you send them off to school with a bag of chips, a sandwich, some crackers. You know what crackers are made out of? This. Crackers are worse than sugar cookies because they don't even have egg in it. At least the sugar cookies got some egg in it, right? So I think if we just understood how bad this stuff is. And here's the other thing. Is you don't gain weight from the holidays, right? Nobody is nobody's 40, 50, 60, whatever pounds overweight because of Thanksgiving, Christmas, and Easter. It's this kind of stuff in between the holidays on a consistent basis that causes the weight gain, and we're starting it with kids at a very young age, right? So it's the sugar cookies in different forms that we're eating every day and calling it a healthy breakfast because, you know, you need your energy and don't want to eat too much fat. I mean, it's so freaking stupid. It just drives me crazy. But it makes sense. Like, how does it make sense? It's because how are so many kids overweight? How are so many people overweight? It's because of this on a consistent basis. Why are we so sick? Why are kids sick all the freaking time, right? It's because of this on a consistent basis. And then, God, on top of it, they encourage, like, every birthday, every holiday, every this, bring cookies and stuff on top of the garbage. It's just constant, right? And the only way this is gonna change is if, hopefully, someone out there watches this and then makes a change. So here's what you do. Instead of having this for breakfast, you start off with eggs, like a healthy, complete protein loaded with vitamins and minerals, loaded with healthy fats, keeps you full for a long time. Or start off with a good healthy meat, a good healthy nuts, a banana with some almond butter, something that has protein and fat that's filling and packed full of good nutrition that keeps you full for a long time. And then you repeat that for lunch and then repeat that for supper. It would be great if somehow we broke the belief system of breakfast foods created by breakfast food companies, right? So instead of thinking of breakfast as cereals, breads, waffles, pancakes, muffins, garbage, 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 it's all just junk food. If we had like supper for breakfast. So we wake up and we have leftover supper, vegetables and meat for breakfast. So we wake up and we have leftover veggies from supper, mix it with eggs, and that's what we have to start our day. Or if you're not hungry in the morning, just skip it all together, which would be good because we eat too often, like constantly, skip breakfast. It's not the most important meal of the day. And then start off with lunch as a really healthy meal. And then supper, a really healthy meal. And we cut this stuff out. Like, here's the deal too. Like, I'm not super anal. The holidays, knock yourself out. Eat the hell out of this, right? Enjoy yourself. Just don't have it every freaking day like so many people do. That's the issue. It's the little things repeated over and over and over that cause the big problems. Also, it's the little things repeated over and over and over that give you the great results. Just working out a couple times a week. Just drinking water every day. Right, just adding vegetables to your meal. Those little things, they compound to a big, big improvement. So, it's getting long-winded, but I'm hoping that I went out and I $2 freaking cookie, like, you know what's crazy too? Like, oh, eating healthy is expensive. This was two freaking dollars. $2 for, you know what the cost is to make this? Probably like a nickel. I mean, it's just nothing but garbage. There's no cost to this. But yeah, so I went out and I spent $2 that I'm gonna feed to the squirrels. Just to make this video, hoping somebody watches it and you share it and you spread the information and you start buying and giving healthy foods, not only for you, but for your kids and your whole family. Start your day off smart. And then, here's what's really cool, is when you eat like that on a regular basis and the holidays come, you can eat whatever the hell you want for 2, 3, 4 days. It's not gonna make a difference, right? But the cool thing is when you eat healthy on a regular basis and the holidays come, you feel so damn good and your body learns to love eating healthy foods that you don't even crave it. Right? So hopefully this helps somebody, and I am going to go home and feed this to the squirrels.